Hello, and welcome to Maths with J. Here we're looking at modular arithmetic. Initially, we're just concentrating on modulo 12. That's because it will be easier for you to visualise, as you're already familiar with a similar sort of clock. I guess you've noticed there's a couple of differences. You can see that instead of a 12, there's a 0 at the top of the clock. And also, there's only one hand. Most clocks have two, if not three, hands. But in modular arithmetic, we only need to concern ourselves with whole numbers, so we only need the equivalent of an hour hand. So no need for a minute hand, and we certainly don't need a second hand. So we're only going to be interested in the hour hand pointing directly at a number. So for example, it's currently pointing directly at the number 2. So this is a bit like a clock where the time is showing 2 o'clock. And you would know that in 3 hours' time, it would be 5 o'clock. Now this corresponds to the calculation in modular arithmetic of 2 plus 3. So this corresponds to adding 3 onto 2 and getting 5. Now, modular arithmetic isn't quite the same as ordinary arithmetic, in the same way as when you look at a 12-hour clock and you see that the time is 5 o'clock, you know that it could either represent 5 o'clock in the middle of the night, or early in the morning, or 5 o'clock in the early evening or in the late afternoon. So there's 2 5 o'clocks, aren't there? And in some sense, those two things are not quite the same as each other. And yet in another sense, as far as looking at the clock is concerned, those two things look exactly the same. Now, what we do in modular arithmetic is we don't use the equal symbol, but we use the congruent symbol, the symbol for congruent to. So here I'm writing that 2 plus 3 is congruent to 5, and in brackets I'm writing mod 12. The mod 12 just tells us that we're working in modulo 12, that we've got a clock with 12 numbers on it. So that's fairly straightforward. So now let's add 4 onto 5. So 5 plus 4 is 9, just as if we were adding 4 hours onto 5 o'clock, we would get 9 o'clock. So 5 plus 4 is congruent to 9 mod 12. And now if we add 5 onto 9, we get 2. So 9 plus 5 is 2. So 9 plus 5 is congruent to 2 mod 12. So that's like saying 5 hours after 9 o'clock is 2 o'clock. What happens if we add 12 onto 2? Well, we end up at 2 again. So 2 plus 12 is 14, and 14 is congruent to 2. So that's a bit like thinking of the 24-hour clock, where we've got 1400 hours, being the same as 2 p.m. But we could take it further and, for example, add 30 onto 2. So in ordinary arithmetic, we'd get 32. But here you can see that 2 plus 30 is congruent to 8 mod 12. And if we add 5 onto 8, we get 1 mod 12. We could start off with a really big number like 29 and add 72 onto that. What we could do here is say, well, 29 is congruent to 5, 72 is congruent to 0. So when we add those two together, we get an answer of 5. Alternatively, you could add together 29 and 72 first, and then work out what they would be congruent to. So rather than whizzing round and round and round this clock, a faster way to do this would be to think, well, we can always divide the number by 12 and just keep the remainder. So here with the 29, 29 divided by 12 is 2, remainder 5. 72 divided by 12, well, that goes in exactly, so there's no remainder. So the remainders are 5 and 0. The same sort of thing will work for much bigger numbers. So if we wanted to add 243 and 85 together, we can see that 243 divided by 12 is going to have a remainder of 3, because 240 is a multiple of 12. And 85, well, we know that 84 is 7 times 12, so the remainder there is 1. So 243 plus 85 is going to be congruent to 3 plus 1, or just 4 mod 12. So here we've just been looking at addition in modulo 12, where we've been thinking about adding on, going clockwise around the clock. Next time, we'll look at subtraction, which will involve going anticlockwise.